गुड मॉर्निंग टू ऑल. टुडे वी आर स्टार्टिंग अ न्यू चैप्टर ऑफ ग्रामर, कंजंक्शंस. सो फर्स्ट लेट अस स्टडी व्हाट इज अ डेफिनेशन ऑफ कंजंक्शंस. सो अ कंजंक्शन इज अ वर्ड विच कनेक्ट्स टू वर्ड्स और क्लॉजेस और सेंटेंसेस, फ्रेजेस एंड शोज द रिलेशन बिटवीन देम. नाउ यू कैन सी इन द डेफिनेशन टू वर्ड्स आर देयर, क्लॉजेस एंड फ्रेजेस. सो व्हाट आर क्लॉजेस एंड व्हाट आर फ्रेजेस? सो अ फ्रेज इज अ ग्रुप ऑफ रिलेटेड वर्ड्स that does not contain a subject and a verb and it is used as a part of speech. Means it is a group of words but it is not having a subject and a verb. Whereas clause is what? It is a group of words that contains a subject and a verb and it is used as a part of sentence or a sentence by itself. Or in easy language we can say that conjunctions are connecting words. Either they are connecting two words or clauses, sentences or phrases. So now talking about types of conjunctions, you can see on the screen there are three types, okay, given mentioned here. First is coordinating conjunctions, second is subordinating conjunctions, and third one is correlative conjunction. So we'll discuss about each conjunctions which are given here. So first we'll talk about coordinating conjunctions. So coordinating conjunctions are used to link or join two words or phrases that are equally important and complete in terms of grammar when they are compared with each other. Now when you talk about coordinating conjunctions, you can see that this word is given here, fanboys, and this is only to remember all the seven types of coordinating conjunctions. F for A and, N for nor, B but, O for or, Y yet, and S for saw. So now you can see, I can explain you here also. See, this is again the same definition and it is saying that that they are coordinating conjunctions are used to link or join two words or phrases that are equally important and complete in terms of grammar when they are compared with each other. Now the sentences or words, they do not depend on anything to give themselves meaning. They are not depending on each other. Now you can see fanboys. You can see here fanboys. So again, for is because, and in addition, nor and not, but however, or either, yet, but, so, therefore. Now these conjunctions are always placed between the two clauses or words that they are joining. Okay, like I told her to leave, I was very tired. So this is one clause and this is second clause, and this is connect, these two are connected with this conjunction for. Same, I like football and I like hockey, and so on. You can read other sentences also. Now again we'll move to the second type, that is subordinating conjunctions. Subordinating conjunctions are used to join an independent and complete clause with a dependent clause which relies on the main clause for meaning and relevance. Okay, now relies means it is depending, and relevance means it is closely connected. So the first sentence is completely dependent. Okay. Good morning to all. Today we are starting a new chapter of grammar and the name is conjunctions. So what is a conjunction? A conjunction is a word which connects two words or clauses or sentences, phrases, and shows the relation between them. Or you can say in easy language that conjunctions are connecting words. Now when we talk about phrases and clauses, we should know what are phrases and what are clauses. So phrases, a group of related words that does not contain a subject and verb, and it is used as a part of speech. Phrases are what? It is a set of words, but it is not having a subject and a verb, but it is used as a part of speech. Now, Clauses is what? A group of words that contains a subject and a verb, and it is used as part of a sentence or a sentence by itself. Okay, so now we'll talk about types of conjunctions. Coming on the first one, coordinating conjunctions, then is subordinating conjunctions, and then is correlative conjunctions. So first we'll talk about coordinating conjunctions. They are used to link or join two words or phrases that are equally important and complete in terms of grammar when they are compared with each other. Now you can remember they are 7 in number, and how can you remember? With the help of this word, fanboys. F for A and, N nor, B but, O or, Y yet, and S so. Now you can see again, F for, and that is because, and in addition to, nor, and not, but, however, or, either, yet, but, so, therefore. Now you can see here again, same definition is given, that they are used to link or join two words or phrases that are equally important and complete in terms of grammar when compared to with each other. Now the sentences or words do not depend on anything to give themselves meaning. And now it means they are not depending on any one sentence. They are independent. Both are independent. Now these conjunctions are always placed between the two clauses or words that they are joining. Now see, if I say I told her to leave, I was very tired. So these are two, there are two clauses in this sentence. You can see one set of words, and this is another set of words which is having a verb also and a subject also, and they both are connected to each other with the help of this coordinating conjunction, that is for. Now I like football and I like hockey. Same, this is a complete sentence, this is also a complete sentence, and it is connected with and. So now you can read these examples and you can understand again. Now coming to subordinating conjunctions, they are used to join an independent and complete clause with a dependent clause that relies on the main clause for meaning and relevance. Relies means depends, and relevance means closely connected. Means the first sentence or the first clause is independent and complete, and the second one depends on the main clause, okay, for its meaning and relation. Now these are some subordinating conjunctions like although, as, before, once, though, until, whether, and so on. So now again we'll just see. Now you can see subordinating conjunctions, because it is used to show reason. She usually eats at home because she likes cooking. Although, used to show two opposite statements, like although he speaks seldom, he says meaningful words. Whereas is used to show contrast, but is used to join two ideas that are opposite. I am very hungry, but the fridge is empty. Means these are the two opposite ideas. Okay. Besides means in addition. Like she speaks three languages besides Spanish. Unlike means different from, not similar to. Therefore, it is used to show the result or effect of an action. Like she came first, therefore she got a good seat. So this is the effect. Okay, why she got a good seat? Despite is used to introduce a fact that is in sharp contrast with another fact. Okay. Provided means if or only if. Unless means except on the condition. Since and so, they are used to show result. Since I see you, I am better. Whoever says so is a liar. If is used to show condition, yet shows contrast or joins opposites. Okay. After tells about order or sequence. I can pass after the green light is on. Now again coming to correlative conjunctions. They are pairs of conjunctions used in a sentence to join different words or group of words in a sentence together. Whenever correlative conjunctions are used, they will be used in pairs like both and, either or, just as so, neither nor, and so on. Now let's see examples of correlative conjunctions. Okay, one more is left for before going on correlative. Again, we can see some uses of because, however, whereas, and although is given here. Again, because is used to show or give reason, and it is followed by a complete sentence with its own subject and verb. So you can see here the girl ran because she was afraid. So girl and ran, subject and verb both are given. And then it is followed by another sentence. Okay. However is used when we can express a contrast by using the adverb however with two sentences. And it is always followed by a comma. Like he was feeling very ill. However, again comma, he went to school. Whereas is used to link two ideas that contrast with each other. For example, my father is wealthy. Whereas we are poor. So wealthy and poor are opposite to each other. Although is used for introducing a statement that makes the main statement in a sentence seem. Although it rained all the day, we enjoyed the party very much. Okay. So now we'll just study about correlative conjunctions. So they are connectives. Okay. And they are always used in pairs. And these are here, you can see four are given. They are most common correlative conjunctions. Okay. First one is either or, then neither nor, both and, not only, but also. So either or means no one or the other. Means you have to make a affirmative choice. Like you can have either chicken or meat. You have to take one out of the two. Neither not means not any, not a single one. Not one or the other. It is used in making negative choice. He is neither smart nor handsome. Okay. Both means it is used in expressing addition. Like both my father and his brother were born in Canada. Not only but also it is used in expressing addition with emphasis. Emphasis means importance. Not only is TV boring, but it also wastes a lot of time. Now here are some conjunctions, correlative conjunctions. You can see and you can read these examples, like how can you use both and end together. This house is both large and cozy. Then neither nor, he is neither employed nor looking for a job, means not anyone. Okay. Again, there are so many, you can read it out and you can understand. Like neither nor, neither George nor his brother is very tall. So it is not, it is not for George and not for his brother also. Now here you can see some examples are there, conjunctions and examples. So you can just go through it, like both, how can you use both and. Michael can both read and write because she usually eats at home because she likes cooking. Okay. Unless she will be sick unless she stops eating. So you can just read these sentences and understand different kinds of conjunctions.